Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I will be showing you how to create a database and table, also called as collections, in MongoDB. So let's get started. So currently I'm having my MongoDB Compass opened, okay? So MongoDB Compass is nothing but a visualization tool. Like, we can view our database and tables and records inside it. So here you can see. So if you aren't having MongoDB Compass, I would recommend you to download it. So this is the link that you can go and download it, okay? It's like really, really helpful. And I am also having my command prompt, normal command prompt, okay? You can just go to search and type cmd and open it. So first we need to convert this normal command prompt into Mongo shell, okay? Mongo command prompt. So to do that, just go to a command prompt and type mongo, Mongo, okay? And just hit enter. So here you can see it's now changed to MongoDB shell, and you'll be also having command prompt Mongo over here. So the first important command is show DBS. This command is used to basically list all the databases that are present in your local system. So just come down over here and type show DBS. So if I just hit enter, it will be showing me all the databases. So see here, the database names in my MongoDB Compass are same to be displayed over here as well. So now to create a database, we will be using use and the database name that we want to create. So I want to create a database named latest, okay? So I'm not having any latest over here, so I will just create a database latest and just hit enter. So it's use latest means automatically it will be switched to the database latest, and my database will also be created. But if I now refresh it, so I'm having 10 databases. If I just refresh my Compass, I'll be having still 10 DBS only. The latest won't appear here. So the reason is because this database latest does not have any data or collection or table inside it, just a database, nothing inside it. So in order to get it listed in my MongoDB Compass, it must have a collection, okay? So to create a collection, what you are doing is db dot your collection name. So this collection is, or table, is going to be created inside your latest database. So db dot your collection name. So I will just name it as latest col for collection, latest col dot insert, just open circular bracket and then curly bracket, and you are going to give in a form of dictionary, okay? Key value pairs. So just open double quotes and let me just put name. I will put colon, name as John, and I will put a comma. I will put double quotes, roll number, colon, and I will just put one, okay? No need double quotes for number, okay? So after that, curly bracket and a circular bracket, okay? So this corresponds to like a name and roll number corresponds to a column, and John and one corresponds to its value, okay? You can like have it like that and just hit enter. So if it comes right, result n inserted one means it has successfully inserted. So now if I just go and refresh my Compass, I will be having 11 DBS and latest will be appearing over here. So if I just refresh it now, so here you can see I'm having 11 and my latest is over here. If I just now go inside it, latest call is my collection name, and if I just click it, I'll be having John and one. So this directly corresponds to our latest call and insert. So this is why you need to have MongoDB Compass. It makes our work so, so simple. So now we are done with it. Let's suppose say that we also want to insert some other value, like another row. Okay. So same command, db latest call insert. So just come here. Instead of John, I will just give some J alone. Okay. Roll number, I will just put it as 2. Okay. Same thing. And I can just hit enter. So I'll be getting again inserted. So if I just now come to my particular collection, that is latest call, and if I just refresh it, I'll be having the second value also inserted. And let's suppose say that you want to insert some value to an existing database itself. So here you can see I'm having these many databases over here. And let's say that I want to insert in my SpringDB, okay? I want to have a table or a collection inside my SpringDB. So for that, you can just come here, you can just use spring double G and a DB, just hit enter. So now I am inside this particular database. So this database over here already has a collection, okay? So we will be creating a new collection for that. So it's, I will just do the same thing. You can have same table name within different databases, okay? So if I just now hit enter, this will be inserted. So if I just now refresh this, so here, if I just scroll down, I will be having two tables or collection within the SpringDB. And if I just click it now, I'll be having the value. So that's it for this video. This is how you create a database as well as a collection or table in MongoDB. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, as well as Node.js and MongoDB. So you can just check those videos. Subscribe me, it helps me a lot. And thanks for watching.